My intention is to give you some tools to sharpen your imagination so that your influence as a leader in your cause is ramped up, your ability to communicate in all areas of your life will be raised, and your ability to work as a fundraiser and as a direct marketer will also be increased. And we're going to start with a question. And the question is, if you had a magic wand and could change one thing within the next 6 months that would help, would have a positive impact on your life and help advance your cause, what would that change? What would you change? Now, you don't have to answer that question now, but we're going to end this program with an answer to that question. Here's how we're going to do it. And I'm going to give you the tools to do this. I'm going to have you answer the question in one paragraph, as if you have already achieved it. And you'll understand why I'm doing that when you understand how the mind works. And then I'm going to have you write down an action step. I'm going to have you seal this in an envelope, address it to yourself, leave it by the door, and it's going to be mailed back to you in 1 month. Now, what's going to happen between this question and that experience? We're going to start looking at the imagination, and we're going to begin with my least favorite demonstration. Where you choose to focus unleashes the power of your imagination to create an experience, your experience. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, at the count of three, I'm going to take a bite out of this lemon. And I want you to imagine, to pretend that you have a lemon, as a child would do. One, two, three. How many of you, either just before I bit the lemon, at the very moment I bit the lemon, or slightly after I bit the lemon, had some sort of reaction to that? Just raise your hands. All right, put your hands up high. Now look around. Look around. Thank you. I ask 500 people to imagine something, and over 90% of you created a biochemical, neurological change in your body with your mind in less than a tenth of a second. That's like a miracle. That's the power of communication. And I did that through words. You do it through marketing. I'm a fear of failure. It's lesson learning. It's opportunity. But if I'm driven by the fear of failure, what won't I take? Risk, no growth, right? The other side of that, I take stupid risk without a vision. But the big one is the fear of change. And the reason the big one is the fear of change is because that's growth. The more we're pressed into doing something new, the more we need to change. The more we need to change, the more resistance there can be unless we know how to work with change. Do me a favor, put your hands together like this. Take them apart, move them over one digit, put them back together, and shout out the adjectives that describe the difference from here to here. Awkward, uncomfortable, unbalanced. Now make a fist and press it against the palm of your hand for me. A little pressure. Now, I didn't say to resist with your other hand, did I? You just did that, naturally. So resistance to change is natural and does not have to stop us from changing. Let me talk a little about how do we break through change. Well, first of all, is to recognize this. Every fear that dominates us gives us something. So the question to ask is, what's the payoff for the fear? Who or what do I get to avoid? Because there's always a payoff. The second question is really wonderful. What's the worst that can happen, and am I willing to have it happen? It's called a reality check.